Hello everyone, today I'll be talking about modified stop and chop, especially for beginners. And this is the technique I usually follow in all my cases except for very soft cataract, wherein I just try and do phaco aspiration if possible. But for all cataracts, be it grade 2, grade 3 or even a harder cataract, modified stop and chop is a better technique. And in my next video, I would be showing how modified stop and chop is better for hard cataracts and what are the advantages that you get usually doing a modified stop and chop technique. So in this case, I will be discussing about the details of modified stop and chop and how it is different from stop and chop. So in stop and chop, what you do is you make a trench and then you divide it mechanically with the help of phaco probe and chopper, or maybe two instruments like chopper and dialer, and then you rotate and you have two halves left, and then each half you bury your phaco probe in foot position 3 and then come to foot position 2, and then you try maintain that hold, and then you crack, and then you get pieces which you emulsify later on. So in this case, I would be showing what was different, and as you can see that I am making rexes in this case, and it is always easy, I feel, with your tratas to make rexes rather than with cystitome, because it is more controlled. And just in case if you land up with any peripheral extension, it is always easy with the help of your tratas to just pull it inside. So now with this, I injected visco in the anterior chamber, and now I'll be taking the phaco probe inside the anterior chamber, and look here, I am dialing the nucleus. And the settings in phaco 1 are like, phaco is power is around 50 and vacuum around 80 to 100, aspiration is around 26, and then you have to make a small and deep trench. And why small? Because then you have ample length material in front to hold. So see, I'm making this trench, but it's not too long, but a short trench, and I'll be making it deep so that the glow is visible from behind. And as you can see, I'm almost done with my tunnel. The tunnel is small and deep, and you can appreciate the glow. Now you have ample lens material in front to hold, and after holding you make a crack. And so this is what is different from your conventional stop and chop. And now again, I'm holding the pieces and breaking it into two, and see, these are soft pieces. And what you have to do, you have to go to foot position 3 in phaco 2 and come to foot position 2, maintain that hold and then crack. So the trench part is in phaco 1 and the holding part is in phaco 2. The phaco 2 settings are power again around 50 to 60, your aspiration is around 36, and vacuum is between 300 to 400. I usually prefer keeping the vacuum at 400. And when you have made these 3 to 4 pieces or maybe 6 pieces, then these are very soft pieces, it is easy to emulsify. And as you can see that this is a totally unedited video, and as I have highlighted in all my previous videos also, if you do all steps of the surgery fine and slowly also, still the surgery is very fast. So this surgery is total of about less than 5 minutes duration. Now irrigation and aspiration was done, and as I always highlight that you have to hold the cortex, peel it towards the center, and then aspirate, as then you are safe. Just in case if you are holding the capsule, you will feel the traction. And once the irrigation aspiration was done, the IOL was implanted using hydro implantation technique. So I get queries about hydro implantation techniques, is it safe and do we have any problems implanting hydro implantation technique. So to tell you about hydro implantation, it is very easy and very safe, and whatever visco you inject, it actually gets out through the side port. If you can watch that, I would be showing it again in one of my videos. And the only problem one can face is with the hydrophobic aisles, because they unfold slowly, so one has to be careful with hydrophobic aisles. But with hydrophilics, again, it is very easy, and with hydrophilic aisles you can just deposit it with the help of your aspiration cannula. And in case of hydrophobic, you may require a dialer to deposit it inside the bag. So now you can see the IOL was well inside the bag, and now finally the wound closure. So this was the modified stop and chop for beginners. For any queries, you can email me at ashishmitra14@gmail.com and subscribe me on YouTube at ashishmitra14. Thank you for watching this video.